A while ago I posted some quick instructions on how to assemble a Granberg mill and said I was going to put an update on how I did my guide system. Never got around to that, so here it is. You can see there's nothing terribly complicated to it. I used 3/4 inch OSB for the sides. I cut those in my shop, but you could also have the hardware store do that. Advantage of OSB is that it stays straight and pretty flat. So once you get the spacing down the middle, you should be able to nice straight cut for your initial cut on the logs. To mount it on there, I'd used a couple different systems. One was nailing a guide on the end of the board going horizontally, but that worked on anything shorter than 8 foot because this is an 8 foot guide system. So what I did today is I just cut a little piece of thermally modified ash that I had sitting around and just put a bolt through there that's attached with a knob on the other side, and that lets me set the rail system onto the log, and then I can just adjust these two pieces and put a short screw through the bottom. And at this point, because the rail system is sitting on the log itself, there's really not much that this is doing other than keeping it from shifting around. So you just get that horizontal so it stays stable. And that's it. Let's make a cut.
Oh.
And there we have the end result. Everything is stacked and stickered. Stickered meaning that put these little thin strips of wood here, about 3/4 inch, to provide some spacing in between the boards so that the air can get through there and help dry them out. If you don't put in stickers, it'll never dry evenly. It'll only dry on the outside of the pile. But really, you want to be able to transport the air off of the face of these boards. And to assist with that, I have just a cheap $10 box fan running at low speed. And I also have a dehumidifier on a pretty high setting, so it's not drying out the air too much, just taking out some of the excess moisture. That'll kick on periodically. If you dry out the wood too quickly, it'll crack and split. So ideally, you want to allow a nice even transition of the wood in the center of the board to the outside, to the face, so it can evaporate. And you'll see I already got some cracking on some of these, but this was to be expected. This is actually probably one of the nicer pieces in the stack. The reason for the crack in the center is that that's the pith of the tree. This is dead center in the tree, so that was never going to survive first contact. But the nice thing about this board, the reason it's one of the nicer ones, is that everything coming out from that is just about perfectly quarter sawn. So this will stay very flat in this direction and may get a little bit of movement side to side, but this would be great for a flat panel for a tabletop or something where I don't want to have a whole lot of wood movement. And then I just left this one 3.5 inches thick, and it's going to go nuts probably as it starts to dry, but the plan is to just cut off the pith and that juvenile wood in the center, because that's no good. And I can make maybe some legs or something from the outside. And on top, just to help weight it down, I have a couple of oak boards that I cut a while ago. They're just providing weight, and they happen to fit on there nicely. And then I have another piece of poplar on the top. And also weighted down with a bunch of turning blanks. So that's the idea. You finish cutting the wood, make sure you stack it up as soon as possible. Seal the end grains with something. I use something called anchor seal. Which you can either order anchor seal, which is kind of pricey, or you can just use anything that would seal the wood, like latex paint or wax or wood glue mixed with water, you know, thin down a little bit with water. It doesn't really matter as long as you seal the end grain. I've just been doing enough of this lately. I decided to splurge on some anchor seal. And that's it. I hope this was helpful, and I hope you have fun with your chainsaw and Granberg mill.